Hello, welcome back to Storytime. We're continuing with Alice in Wonderland, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, the first story of the Alice in Wonderland duology. And Snockings, I think, has decided to join us. She likes to get in the way, don't you? All right, anyways, off. We were just about to go to the Mad Tea Party. Chapter 7, A Mad Tea Party. There was a table set out under a tree in front of the house, and the March Hare and the Hatter were having tea. A dormouse was sitting between them fast asleep, and the other two were using it as resting their elbows on it and talking over its head. Very uncomfortable for a dormouse, only as it's asleep, I suppose it doesn't mind. Part 1, but the three were all crowded together at one corner of it. No room, no room, and they saw Alice coming. There's plenty of room, said Alice indignantly, and a large armchair at one end of the table. Have some wine, the March Hare said in an encouraging tone. Alice looked all round the table on it, but tea. I don't see any wine, she remarked. There isn't any. Then it wasn't very civil of you to offer it, said Alice angrily. It wasn't very civil of you to being invited, said the March Hare. I didn't know it was your table, said Alice. Great many more than three. Your hair wants cutting, said the Hatter. He had been looking one time with great curiosity, and this was his favorite speech. You should learn not to make personal remarks, Alice said with some severity. The Hatter opened his eyes very wide on hearing this. But all it was, why is a raven like a writing desk? Come, we shall now, thought Alice. I'm glad they've begun asking. I believe I can guess that, she added aloud. Do you mean that you think you can find out the March Hare? Exactly so, said Alice. Then you should say what you mean, the March Hare. I do, Alice hastily replied. At least I mean what I say. That's the same. Not the same thing a bit, said the Hatter. Well, you might just as well say what I eat is the same thing as I eat what I see. You might just as well, the March Hare, that I like what I get is the same thing as I get what I like. You might just as well, the Dormouse, who seemed to be talking in his sleep, that I breathe when I sleep is the sleep when I breathe. It is the same thing with you, said the Hatter. And here the party sat silent for a minute, while Alice thought over all she could remember about writing desks, which wasn't much. The Hatter was the first to break. What day of the month is it? He said, turning to Alice. His watch out of his pocket and was looking at it uneasily, shaking it every now and then and holding it to his ear. Alice considered a little and said, the 4th. 2 days wrong. I told you butter wouldn't suit the works, he added angrily at the March Hare. It was the best butter, said March Hare meekly. Yes, but it got in as well, the Hatter grumbled. You shouldn't have put it in with the bread knife. March Hare took the watch and looked at it gloomily. Then he dipped it into his cup of tea, but he could think of nothing better to say than his first remark. It was the best butter. Alice had been looking over his shoulder with some curiosity. What a funny watch. It tells the day of the month, and it doesn't tell what o'clock it is? Why should it? Muttered. Does your watch tell you what year it is? Of course not, Alice replied very readily. Because it says stays the same year for such a long time altogether. It is just the king, said the Hatter. Alice felt dreadfully puzzled. The Hatter did hear, it seemed to her, to have no sort of meaning in it, and yet it was certainly English. I don't quite understand you, she said, as politely as she could. The Dormouse, said the Hatter, and he poured a little hot tea onto its nose. The Dormouse patiently and said without opening his eyes, Of course, just what I was going for. Have you guessed the riddle yet? The Hatter said, turning to Alice again. Alice replied, what's the answer? I haven't the slightest idea, said the Hatter. Nor I. Alice sighed wearily. I think you might do something better with the time, she said, in asking riddles that have no answers. If you knew time as well as I, you wouldn't talk about wasting it. It's him. I don't know what you mean. Of course you don't, the Hatter said, tossing his head con-